So sad. Just look at the sadness in that lady's face.
If you grew up in the 60s, you grew up with war on TV every night.
So heartbreaking.
War that your friends were involved in. And,
Hi beautiful people, I'm back, but clearly I'm back with another reaction video. And guess what? As the title suggests, I'm back with another Bruce Springsteen song. And this time round, I'm going to be watching the song War. And from the title, I assume it's talking about war. So we'll find out about that shortly. And I'm hoping that you're going to take this journey with me all the way to the end of this video. And as per usual, I'll be giving my comment as well as interpretation at the end of it. So I hope to see you there. And if this is the kind of content you're interested in, look no further, because you're right in the right place. So kindly go ahead right now and do that thing, smash on that red subscribe button down below if you haven't done so already, and join me, and together let's enjoy this and many more videos to come. So without further ado, let's get into this song War by Bruce Springsteen and see what he's got to say about it, and see you at the end.
We acknowledge that 2,000 to 4,000 troops are now in Vietnam, but the administration stresses that these forces are not in combat, but serving as military advisors to the Army of the Republic of South Vietnam. In other news, President Johnson announced tonight in a televised address to the nation that American fighting forces in Southeast Asia would increase from 75 to 125,000 men.
That's a large
number. Would be ordered and needed. And this morning, Richard M. Nixon was sworn in as the 37th President of the United States. In Vietnam this week, 185 Americans have been killed and 1,237 wounded as fighting continues.
So sad. Just look at the sadness in that lady's face.
If you grew up in the 60s, you grew up with war on TV every night.
So heartbreaking.
War that your friends were involved in. And I want to do this song tonight for all the young people out there. If you're in your teens, because I remember a lot of my friends when we were 17 or 18, we didn't have much of a chance to think about how we felt about a lot of things. And the next time, they're going to be looking at you, and you're going to need a lot of information to know what you're gonna wanna do.
Not true.
Because in 1985, blind faith in your leaders or in anything will get you killed.
So sad.
Because what I'm talking about here is
I'm love the anger. Just see that. So sad. Imagine seeing this on television each and every day during the, he said 80s. And he also said in the 70s, the same thing used to happen. So it's just a sad situation seeing how like politicians use the normal citizens to go and fight, yet it's as the chorus was saying, whoa, what is it good for? Absolutely nothing. And there must be another way to resolve all this rather than war. Because I love the line that was saying, war is only good for the, like those that are the one gaining from it. But if you are the one sending your sons or you are the sons going to fight, you are risking your life. It's a 50, actually, I don't know whether it's a 50-50, but chances of you surviving are like you've given out your life. So in case you die, you die. In case you survive, you survive. But you can imagine even surviving the trauma, the experience. It's just absolutely nothing. So yeah, there must be another way to do things differently. So that was about war. I tend to believe this song came out during the World War, maybe. So I assume so. I don't really know. And it must have been during the Vietnam War, actually, because at the beginning they were talking about the Vietnam War. So let me know in the comment section what this means to you. And if you were there during this time, like how was life for you? And did you participate in the Vietnam War? Or like where were you in life at that time? Because it must be a hard time, especially for youths, because they had to be sent to go to the war and fight for their nations. Yet they, I love the fact that at the beginning you saw how that lady looked so devastated. She looked so sad and just so like she was just not looking okay. And that shows how like the impact that the family of those that go to war are left feeling, like the impact it has on family and friends and like acquaintances. It's just not a good experience. And I love the fact that I love that chorus that says, what is it good for? Absolutely nothing. It's the answer is totally true. And we have to find ways to solve things differently and not like get into war. So basically that's all I can say. And I hope that I can hear from you. And let me know what you think of it. And of course, if you have a different interpretation, kindly consider to leave a comment. So for me, I'll just go by the title. It's just about war. And to be specific, I'd say the Vietnam War. And I loved, one thing that I loved about this song was the way from the beginning, you could see, you could hear and see from Bruce Springsteen's facial and even body movement and voice, the vocals, you could see he's singing with a lot of anger and bitterness. So it's really a hard topic. And I love how he sang about it and the fact that he's telling the young people, the teens, like so that when it gets to that time they are needed to do that, they can make like good decisions. And basically that's so. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope you enjoyed it, or actually not enjoyed, but you learned something from it. Yeah, so let me know what is your takeaway from it, and let me know also what your interpretation it is. And if you enjoyed it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you're new here, welcome and feel right at home. Don't forget to smash the red subscribe button down below if you haven't done so already, so that you can officially be part of this beautiful, amazing family, and together we can enjoy such videos going forward. Also, if you'd love to be notified each and every time I post a video, kindly consider to smash the notification bell so that you don't miss out on any episode going forward. Last but not least, if you'd love to support this channel, you're welcome to do so. All you need to do is check the description below, where you'll find the link to my Patreon community as well as my PayPal address. And you can as well have guaranteed requests through either platforms. So once again, thank you so much for watching this with me. Asanteni sana, that is Swahili for thank you so much. And it's always a pleasure. And every day it's a new experience, a new lesson learned. And yeah, so every day we keep growing together. So I hope you feel that. So see you in the next episode. And until then, take care of yourself. Be safe. And for now, peace out and bye.